you are new here, hi, I'm Mary. And if you're returning viewer, thank you for coming back. Today's video is going to be a little different. We are going to talk about the beauty community and what's going on. And also, I am going to include some of the empties that I have and whether I am going to repurchase or not, or if I already have. Okay, first thing is the Morphe setting spray. I love this. It is an amazing setting spray. I don't know if you know this, but they do have a dewy one if you don't like this. I like the regular formulation of this. It leaves you in between matte and dewy. I also own the dewy one and I as well love that one. I already repurchased this, so yeah. Beauty community, Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson. What a mess they have made. I guess the main point I'm trying to make in this video is that from right now, the time that you're watching this video, I will no longer be supporting Jeffree Star Cosmetics. And what I mean by supporting is I will not be purchasing any new products from Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I'll explain why. Let me move on to the next thing. Next thing is going to be the Soap and Glory Toner Water. So this is a toner. You can definitely remove your makeup with this, but I mainly use it as my toner at night. And as you can see, it's a big bottle and it's gone. I already repurchased this. I love it. Super affordable. You can get it at Target. So I definitely think it is a really, really, really good toner. Okay, so no longer supporting Jeffree Star Cosmetics. As you all know, since I have done some reviews of his products on my channel, I definitely do enjoy his products. Eyeshadow palettes are great, lipstick stuff is great, highlighter is great, I've tried the powder, the concealer. His products are of good quality and I definitely have endured them. So, what do I mean by I will no longer be supporting Jeffree Star Cosmetics? I am not going to actually get rid of all of the Jeffree Star Cosmetics products that I have. I paid money for that. It would just, with what's going on right now in the situation and work and whatever, I cannot fathom throwing stuff away just because of how I am feeling right now. I can't. I will not be throwing it away, but I will not be using his products on my channel, and I also will not be tagging any Jeffree Star Cosmetics product that I do end up having on if I post a picture on my Instagram account. Let's pause on that and go to the next thing. This is the Kate Somerville Biomimicking Peptides Serum. I got this in a BoxyCharm, and if you guys remember, I actually canceled my BoxyCharm subscription. Even though all the products in there were great and I enjoyed them, I just felt like I have too much to just be getting makeup just because. For me, as of right now, it just didn't make sense to keep the subscription, especially since I'm trying to use up some of the stuff that I already have. It just doesn't make sense to keep getting new stuff, you know? This is a beautiful serum. It does have an odd scent. It kind of, oh, it still has a little bit left. It kind of reminds me of oatmeal, but like just plain oats with water. It works great. It works beautiful. Do I think it was something that changed my skincare world? No. Do I think it's worth repurchasing? No. I think this is like $80. Yeah. I don't think I'm okay with paying $80 for a serum. Maybe like $40 or $50, but $80, I'm like, I don't know. Really good, but I'm not going to be repurchasing it. Now, let's move on to Shane Dawson. Oh, Shane, Shane, Shane. I doubt he'll even see this, but I still definitely want to talk about what he said. I do not agree with him calling the beauty community toxic and a circus because I just don't agree with it. The reason a community or a group or a clique or a place, anything is toxic is because there are toxic people in that community. What do? You get rid of the toxic people. That's the truth. Hold that thought. Next thing is the Hydrobiotic Recovering Sleepy Mask by Dr. Brent. When I first tested this out, I think I tested it out for 2 or 3 weeks. I got this in a BoxyCharm and I wasn't sure about it. I did not feel like it was even doing anything to my skin. Well, I wanted to use it up, so I kept using it. And in order for you to actually see a difference on your skin with this, you have to use it for a month or longer. Out of everything today, this is one of the more expensive items. And if I could replace this right now, I would, because I definitely feel like it really, really, really helped out my skin, especially on those weeks where I felt like my skin was really, really, really struggling. So I definitely really enjoyed this, and I took a picture of this so that when I do have the funds to purchase it, I'm going to purchase it because it was that great. Okay, back to the whole Shane Dawson. If you like drama, then you will watch some of the top YouTubers who thrive on the drama. I know so many beauty and makeup like YouTube channels that have nothing to do with that drama. So for him to generalize the whole community, that was very wrong of him to do, because it's the same thing like as what's going on right now with the BLM movement and the whole cops thing. It's like you cannot generalize a whole group just because of a small percentage of that group's actions. You can't. It's just not fair. I just what he said did not sit well with me. Like, even though I'm a small beauty makeup YouTube channel, I still feel that we need to speak up, and I still feel that somehow in some way we make a small impact on the choices that we make. I still feel like the few people that do watch, like, it'll help in some way. Let's pause and talk about the next item. It is going to be the Milk Kush Mascara by Milk Makeup. I got this in a little bundle that came with the mascara and a couple of other primers. I mainly got it because I wanted to test out the Hydro Grip Primer, but I didn't want to spend the $30 on the big bottle. Even though it's a good mascara, it has a very weird scent, which I couldn't get over. It does kind of flake a little bit. So even though it's a good mascara, I don't think it's like amazing to where I'm going to repurchase this. Like, it was just nice that I got in the little bundle. The next two items are the ColourPop and e.l.f. Brow Pencils. Both of these are completely out and gone. These are two very affordable brow pencils that work just as good as your higher end ones. As you can tell, these are both gone and I already repurchased. There is one thing I have always said, and probably not on here, mostly like on my social media, and that is with everything that keeps happening in this world, with all the crap, the one main problem that everything has in common is us humans. We are unfortunately the ones at fault for things turning into shit. We really are. We are the problem, us humans. And I'm not saying everyone, but I'm just saying in certain situations when it goes from good to bad, it is because a certain individual made it to go to crap. One of our biggest flaws as humans is that we let a lot of our decisions and words we say sometimes be led by our emotions instead of sitting down, analyzing, you know, thinking everything through and then making a firm decision. So at the end of the day, us humans are the ones that are creating all of this chaos. And right now, as certain individuals, and I think the only way that we can stop is if we stop supporting them. And even though it sounds harsh, and I know we hate cancel culture, at the end of the day, they only have power because we give them power. Think about that. Next item is going to be the Chi Helmet Head Hairspray. This is the small bottle. I use this for my brows. So I spray it and then I set my brows in place. I love this. I use this instead of brow gel and I already replaced it because I love it so much. You can use whatever hairspray you want, but I figured I would throw it in there because I've already gone through one of these, and you know, for it just being used on my eyebrows, because I don't use hairspray, it gives me dandruff, so I don't put any hairspray on my hair. But just to go through this whole thing for my brows, I mean, that's pretty impressive, right? The next thing is the Wet n Wild Coconut 3-in-1 Primer Water. This I love. This is my third one replacing already. Well, I'm on my third bottle. I love how it smells. It honestly gives me the perfect finish to my makeup. It's great, super affordable, and if you haven't tried it, you definitely need to try it. So as far as Shane Dawson, I do watch his channels. Well, I think he's going to get rid of the Shane Dawson one, probably. I don't even know what's going to happen with like his collection with Jeffree Star. Jeffree Star has been very quiet lately. I don't think I've seen anything from him other than just Instagram stories of him and his dogs, but like him speaking about what's going on and what people keep saying and what receipts and all that. He hasn't said much other than what he recently posted, given his side of the story and whatnot. At this point in time, I feel like he's a broken record. You can't keep saying sorry and expect to just keep being forgiven every time. It's like the boy who cried wolf. You can't. It's like you either completely change or you don't. Period. It's all honestly very draining. At the end of the day, we honestly don't know what the 100% truth is. At the end of the day, you are still going to have people on this side who want Jeffree Star to go down. Jeffree Star's side who does what he does for whatever reasons he does it, because I don't understand sometimes what I hear that he has done. I'm just like, how and why and what is going through your head? You know? It honestly is so confusing. It's hard to even know what to believe anymore. So for my sanity, I just decided I am just no longer going to purchase Jeffree Star Cosmetics. And there is a lot of other great makeup items out there that are just as great or better, but it's not like I'm missing out, you know? Yeah. Okay, I have three more items and then we're done with my empties. The next one is going to be Good Molecules. This is that little cleansing balm. I actually got this for free in one of my Beautylish orders. So I got this for free. And if you guys watch Robert Welch and his brother, I think it's James Welch, they talk about how absolutely horrible makeup remover wipes are for your skin. And you should really stop using them and use a cleansing balm. And it's also like, you know, better for the environment. I went ahead and used this up to see if it's a route I was going to go towards. I actually really enjoyed the fact that you literally put this and melt your makeup away, you wash it off, and then you'll go about your skincare routine. I used up the last of my makeup wipes. I did not purchase Good Molecules. I went ahead and purchased a different one. The one I purchased was $10. I don't even remember the brand, but it works just as great. It takes off my makeup and makes it melt away, and it makes things easier when I am ready for my makeup to come off. Okay, last but not least is actually a hair product. Makeup by Susie, I think that's her name, recently talked about this brand on her Instagram stories, and that is Monette. The reason I started using Monette after having heartburn, I knew I was going to start losing my hair at 3 or 4 months. I did some research. Luckily for me, a couple of the girls from my gym were already using this product or products from this brand. They told me, you know, how amazing it is and how it has really, really, really helped their growth of their hair. I thought to myself, let me try it. It wouldn't hurt. It will either work or it won't. I purchased it right as I was close to giving birth to Harper. As soon as I did, I started using it after she was born. Let me tell you how amazing it is and how it saved my hair. Wow. My hair is in such good shape. It's growing so fast. And honestly, it is, at least the products that I've been using have been working amazing for me. If you are one of those people who is having issues with your hair growing, the thickness of your hair, check them out. I know there are some controversies out there. Some people did not have good experience with some of these products, but I feel like with everything, just do your research. Find out what product is specifically for you. Try it out. It either works or it doesn't. It's going to be 2 years now that I've been using it. The beauty community and the beauty YouTubers that are not part of that toxic circus is part of the reason why I'm still doing this. I love making YouTube videos. I don't know what it is about it. I love makeup. I will always love makeup. And as long as I keep enjoying this, I'm going to keep doing it. And also, as long as there is still amazing drama-free beauty YouTubers out there, I will keep doing it, because the couple bad apples that make the beauty community a toxic circus, those are the bad apples that you need to just stop watching. As soon as you do, you will see how much you actually don't even need to see those people. They get PR. They're not doing this, well, I'm not saying all of them, but most of them are not doing it anymore because they actually care about you. They're doing it because they're gonna get a paycheck, they're gonna get views, promotion for their products that are coming out a week from their last video. Find beauty YouTubers in a community that is actually putting out content because they genuinely care about telling you how good or how bad a product is. Find those people and you will be absolutely happy, and you won't have any drama or toxicity on YouTube. This video, I know, probably is coming off as a little bit of a rant, but I honestly felt like I needed to say something, and I also wanted to share my empties with you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was a little bit different, but I really, 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 really feel like, even though I am like a micro times a thousand influencer, I don't even like that word, but YouTube channel, let's say that, I still feel like me speaking up about this and standing up and saying I will no longer allow these toxic people to bring toxicity into the beauty community. I am standing with the beauty community and not with these people. I do want to say that just because I am no longer going to support Jeffree Star Cosmetics by purchasing, it doesn't mean that I'm going to talk down on anyone who does. And I ask the same from you guys. You are free to do whatever you want. You are an adult. You have the right to make your own decisions. But I will not be defending. I will not be talking crap. I will not be talking down to anyone who still decides to support Jeffree Star. I'm just letting you guys know where I stand and where I am at, and I am okay if you don't agree with me. It's totally okay. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. If you haven't done so already, I would love it if you joined my small YouTube family. I would love to have you. I will see you guys on the next video. Bye. Especially cinema. Oh.